we are distributing the magazine back to Godhead, and we are just resting here for 5-10 minutes. Then the other person went upstairs, and his father was a good close friend of Prabhupada, but he was a Arya Samaji. So they were distributing book. Prabhupada used to go to him, and then but he never took this magazine. Prabhupada struggled with him. But at that time, the people, they went upstairs, and then they said, "Oh, you are from the same Swamiji." They used to call Swamiji at that time. "Oh, you are from the same Swamiji." The Godhead, "Oh, he used to do this. But these devotees, they went to him after so many years, and his family was convinced that this book has some value on it. Let's try it. After a few months, he was one of the devotees of ISKCON. And there are many devotees Prabhupada created like this. And one of the example I will share with you, Dr. Radha Krishna Swarupali, you must have heard, the one of the president of India. He was a Mayavadi. When Prabhupada was there, Prabhupada approached him many times. And you know how to get to a president is very difficult in India, but somehow Prabhupada got to him. And then he said, "Okay, Prabhupada, all good, but I don't believe in Krishna consciousness. I will not take it." Prabhupada tried writing him letters many times, and went to see him many times, but he did not budge from his stand. But he said at the end, when Prabhupada was coming to US, he said, "Okay, I will do this, what you are telling me. I'll help you, but after my retirement." But he was still speaking all Mayavadis and all that. Then Prabhupada was in US, and one day there was a newspaper, that big newspaper, that $2, $1 book, on the corner store you get the book, small newspaper. In the newspaper, one of the devotee saw this one, Dr. Radha Swarupali retires. Then he took that same newspaper to Prabhupada, and he showed it to Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, "Oh, what? Oh, yes, good. Now I'm going to see him when I go back to India." But he's still Mayavadi. Prabhupada has his in mind, okay, he's still Mayavadi. He won't, maybe he will not listen, but I'll try. Prabhupada went back to India. He wrote many letters to him. Finally, he got the appointment to see him. The appointment was, I think, 2 weeks or 3 weeks late. But Prabhupada again was not convinced that he will convert himself to Krishna consciousness. He was not convinced. But within, this is Krishna arrangement, he had heart attack. Dr. Radha Swarupali had heart attack. He could not speak. He has paralysis. He could not speak. And the news came to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, he cannot see you because he's in intensive care unit, and he can't see you. And Prabhupada was happy. Prabhupada said to his devotees, "Yes, this is Krishna's arrangement. Krishna doesn't want him to speak any more Mayavadi philosophy. That's the arrangement. I was telling him to stop this Mayavadi philosophy, and you come back, might not have the situation what you have today." So Prabhupada has created so many things, and so many, he has given us basically, like when you buy a new house and you go there and the people give you the key, and then you just enter, you have everything, how you feel. Same way Prabhupada has given us the key. The same key opens and same key locks. The only thing is which one you want to use. Prabhupada has given a key which is all spiritual, all the way spiritual. You will not come back. And we can compare Prabhupada with Raja Janak. Like when he left his body, then Vishnu Dut came to take him to the Vaikuntha. Then he said, Okay, I will come with you, but I want to see the Narak first, right? I was listening to Navigendra Maharaj, he was explaining this. Then Raja Janak told them, "Okay, one, I will go with you, but I want to see the Narak first, the hellish planet first." They said, "We cannot do this, we cannot go." Then Janak Maharaj says, "Okay, you leave me the main entrance, I'll go in, you'll be outside." Then Raja Janak went in, and he saw everybody's crying, the different kinds of problems, different different kinds of miseries happening all over the planet. And then the moment they saw, they were all happy. They're all happy just to see Janak, the Janak King Janak, just to see. And everybody, like, he saw a few people, they're okay, they're okay, they're okay. Everybody, the word spread around, they're getting better and better and better and better. Then the people from outside, they're waiting. They say, oh, we are waiting, let's go, it is time to go. Then Janak said, okay, no, I will go. We'll go together, provided you take all these people with me. Then they said, no, we cannot do this. We cannot do this. It's not possible for us to do it because we are not empowered that way that we can do this. But they said, there's one way to do it. You give them all your pious credit slowly and slowly, like each of them, they all will get liberated. They all get liberated. So then Janak Maharaj started giving all his pious credit, and everybody from the Hellas planet, they were all liberated, and they went to all the Vaikunthas. This is the empowerment of the real devotees. So Prabhupada is like, we can't even imagine like what level Prabhupada was. He is on the deathbed and he is telling, don't take me to any hospital. And he's just preaching at the same time. And today you can write in Word, Excel, whatever you want to write. But in those days, you have to write on your paper. And you know, Prabhupada, he used to write so many letters to all the presidents and all that. So it's not easy. He's writing letters in the morning, during daytime. In temple, you have 100 things to do. So it's not Prabhupada writing just books. He was writing the books. When we were sleeping, he was writing books. So he goes like 10 o'clock, we see, okay, 10 o'clock, time to sleep. Prabhupada, 10 o'clock, he goes and he starts narrating and he starts translating all the books. So what Prabhupada has done is not easy to do. Like you just think at this age and compare at the double of your age at that time. It's impossible what he has done. And he has given us a place where you cannot go wrong. That is the base, that's the bottom line, but Prabhupada said. Do we have more time, please? Yeah. And I want to request all of you, don't think that you cannot do book distribution. Please take that thing out of your mind. That's your first step. The second step is just start going. Like the movement started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it was not that people, they were all expert. They were not all expert. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to say, Vichar karite chite paaye chamatkar. Like if you do something if you think something, you will see a chamatkar. So Krishna will give you intelligence. You will get mercy from Prabhupada. So, and you get mercy from Radharani. You'll get mercy from all the devotees around you. And you are fulfilling all the activities what Parikshit Maharaj's teachings. That Parikshit Maharaj at the end of his life, he asked three things. Related to Lord, with Lord always, with association of the devotees, and friendliness with all the human beings. So by doing this one distribution, you are doing all these three things. You are giving them medicine which is required for them. It's basically a vaccine. Everybody is suffering from this disease in material world. Our books are the vaccine. So you need to go out and give it to everyone. Because people say, okay, polio in India, polio vaccines. Oh, we have distributed so many polio vaccines and this we have done, and then we have eradicated the polio completely. It never happens. But for us, we do have, because this is a proven track. It is result oriented. It is not fake. It is real. So Prabhupada's mission is real. So let's take this one with reality. Let's take with this one with some enthusiasm. Let's develop attitude. There's no difference. Just attitude. Everybody can do. If you read big human resources book, you read 10 books, 20 books, but you read the end of the volume, they say every human being can do everything provided he has been given proper opportunity at a proper time. So Prabhupada was expert in giving all his disciples proper opportunity, proper time. That's why, I don't know, we have 55 million plus devotees right now all over the world, and almost 700 plus centers. So we can't expect more, but now this is our duty to fulfill his mission. So we need to go out and do what Prabhupada wanted, what our spiritual master wants. That's the only thing I can request you with folded hands, that please do the book distribution, help all of us and all people around you. So you'll be happy one day. If you see 10 people, tell people they have got something out of it, you'll be happy. And these books are powerful. These books are non-different than the Supreme. They're Krishna there. So I'll share one more story, then I'll end it. In US, in LA, there was a devotee. He bought a big truck, SUV or something. He was not a devotee, but he was friend of a devotee. He was given a book, Bhagavad Gita. Then out of courtesy, his friend, oh, you bought this truck today. Okay, let's try, let's go for a ride. They went for a ride. The other person was driving. And then the car on the highway flipped, and they caught the fire. They caught the fire, but nobody got hurt. Everybody escaped without any, like, small mild injuries, that's it. But after that, the devotee came to know, okay, this thing happened, and then, okay, let me at least go. The car was total loss. There was fire on the tire. This was all burned out. Then the devotee said, okay, let me at least go and see what happened there. Then he saw the car. Car was upside down, all burnt. Then he opened the part that he has a compartment. In the compartment, there was Bhagavad Gita. Nothing happened to Bhagavad Gita. In the compartment, the car was fully burned, and Bhagavad Gita was there. Nothing happened there. So this is the power of this book. This book is not ordinary. We think it ordinary, but it is not ordinary book. It is very, very powerful. So please take advantage of this. Hare Krishna.